Appearing for the Spring 2022 visa interview in the next 10 days, then this is a must-watch video. And this video is going to help you immensely in clearing that visa interview and reaching your university on time. So keep on watching. Hi guys, my name is Shachi and I'm a travel and a visa coach. On this channel, you will find lots of useful videos on the US visa process. There is an entire playlist for F1 visa. There's a playlist for Spring 22. F1 visa interviews, so make sure that you check out all of these videos. So on this channel, there is tons of useful content for F1 visa interview, but if your interview is in the next 10 days, you might not have the time to comb through all this information and digest it. So today's video is for you. This is going to be like a crash course for your visa interview. This is a comprehensive guide covering all the important points, the must knows, the checklist for your visa interview, and along with each point I've also put the detailed explanation and the video link for that, so in case you want to dig deeper or you do have the time, then you can check out that as well. So with this said, let's get started. So first things first, let's start by making sure that you have a visa appointment. So if you already have an appointment, that's great. You are amongst the lucky few, so make sure that you prepare well and maximize that attempt. However, if you still don't have the visa appointment and you're still targeting for Spring 22 intake, then getting an emergency appointment is your best bet. This is something which has been working really well for everybody else out there. So there's a detailed video on how to find an emergency appointment. I'm going to link that video. Make sure that you check it out. If you need my help in drafting the emergency application, please do reach out. And one more thing to keep in mind is that in case your visa date is really close to the program start date, or if it is past the program start date, then you will need an email or a letter from the university which says that they are okay with you joining the classes a few days late. And this email or letter is going to be important both for the visa interview as well as at the port of entry, that is at immigration. So make sure that you prepare for this and get this email, get this letter from your university. The second point that you need to be really well prepared for is funding. Of all the interviews that I have seen in the last 2 months for Spring 22 intake, I see a lot of emphasis being placed on funding. Almost every interview has questions about the sponsor or has questions about how the funding is structured. You really need to make sure that you have got this in place. And funding is not something that you can prepare, just a day before the interview. So prepare this as much as in advance as possible. When you are presenting your funding to the visa officer, you should very clearly tell him how much is from your sponsor, who your sponsor is, how much is from a loan, that is if you have a loan, or if there are any other sources of funding. So this gives a really clear idea to the VO. Also, be very, very clear about your sponsor's annual income, sponsor's profession, and sponsor's net worth or other savings apart from the liquid savings that you're showing for your education. And in the last few months, also another common thing which has been seen is that documents are rarely being asked, but if they're asked, they're being asked for funding. So you also have to make sure that you have all the document proofs in place. So there is a detailed video covering funding in depth. So if you are feeling unsure about your funding plan, make sure that you check out this video. The third point that I want to talk about is the interview experience videos. So going through the interview experiences of students who've already cleared their F1 interview or who already just appeared for the F1 visa interview is going to be really helpful. But there is tons of interview experiences out there, so you might again feel overwhelmed about consuming all this content. And on this channel also, you must have observed that there are interview experiences being put out almost every other day. But if you don't have the time to go through all of these experiences, you can refine these experiences or filter down these experiences by the university that you're going for and also by the embassy location that your interview is scheduled. So on my channel, again, there are all these experiences. So just do a quick search by your university and by your embassy and you'll be able to find the interview experiences which are relevant to you. So if you don't have the time to comb through, the entire data of interview experiences out there, just at least make sure that you are going through the experiences of your university and your location, because this is going to give you a really good idea of how your interview might look like. Also, if you want to look at detailed interview experiences of students and really understand their preparation strategy and how they went about the entire process, then we have these detailed videos on the channel as well. There is a separate video for bachelor's program, for master's, and I think for a double master's as well. So all these videos are going to be linked. You can check it out. The fourth point to keep in mind and to prepare well is the documents. So for the F1 visa interview, one side of the story is, of course, getting ready for the questions, what to say, and the other side of the story is having all your documents in place, especially your academic documents, that is your transcripts, your proof of work experience, and your funding. These are the three main category of documents which are most likely to be asked. Of course, in addition to it, you need to have your basics in place. That's your I-20, your CVIS, your passport. In the last 2 months, again, I saw quite a few students making mistakes when it comes to their CVIS fee payment and having some errors in their I-20, and because of which the interview either had to be postponed or they had to give it again. So do a double check on these essential documents and make sure that all the information is correct and in place. If you're looking for a detailed document checklist video, then there is a video for this. You can go through it. There is also a PDF which gives the entire documents that you need to get it, and this PDF is linked in the description box below. So these two resources will help you to make sure that all your documents are in order. And the fifth point that I want to talk about in this video is the interview questions. So what are the list of questions that you need to be prepared for? So depending upon, again, the interviews which have happened in the last 2 months, we have prepared a PDF, and this PDF is a checklist. It's a list of questions which you need to be prepared for. There is a separate question bank for people who have been rejected previously. So this PDF is linked in the description box below. Just click on the link and get your free PDF, and make sure that all the questions which are listed in this PDF, you know what you have to say. And also the answers have to be concise, cannot be giving really lengthy answers. So also time yourself, make sure that you're not exceeding more than 40 to 50 seconds. There is in fact a video which will give you this live mock interview experience, and I'm going to link this video above. You can click on this video, and in this video you can take a live mock interview with me. So once you have the answers for these questions prepared, you can get some practice using this video. Of course, if you want to do a one-to-one session with me, that is take a mock with me, you can do that as well. So this mock is going to be made very close to the actual visa interview, and this will help you to build confidence, to get practice. There's also detailed answer structuring, which is going to be done at the end of the mock. And all of this will help make sure that you are completely ready for your visa interview. Tons of students have taken the mock interview session with me and found it really useful. So if you would like to take a mock with me, the link for this is in the description box below. So these are the five essential points, a quick guide for those of you appearing for the visa interview in the next 10 days. Even if you don't do anything else, make sure that you have your bases covered for these 5 points. I am sure that you will be prepared enough for the visa interview. If you're looking for a more in-depth prep, you can also check out my F1 prep course. This is a comprehensive course which goes through all the interview questions and how you need to structure the answers for this. Again, this is a course which has helped many students, and I'm sure this is going to help you as well. So the link for this course is in the description box below. So thank you so much for watching. I hope this has helped you. Stay tuned for the next video, because the next video that is going to come up on the channel is going to be all about the immigration process. So a lot of you ask me questions about how immigration really happens and how can you prepare yourself, what are the documents you need for that. So the next video coming up in a few days is going to be all about the immigration process, and I'll also share my personal experience of going through the US immigration. So make sure that you subscribe, you press the bell icon, and so that you don't miss out on this video. That's all for today. Thank you so much for watching. Wishing all of you all the best. If you need any further assistance, if you want to take a one-to-one session or a mock session with me, feel free to reach out. You can always comment below or DM me on Instagram. All right, stay safe and see you in the next one. Bye.